Okay. It has been 6 weeks since I have flown. I think I remember how to do it, but honestly, I'm not sure. Had to rebuild my, or had to replace my head gasket. Had the prop, or the, you know, the prop get into the net. So, fix that. My clear prop. My tack and hour meter quit. So I've done a lot of work. I reinforced my cage again. It looks really bad right now. It looks really generic, but if this works, I'll try to make it look prettier later. And this is December 23rd in Illinois. A year ago, it was 10 below zero with a 35-mile-an-hour wind chill. Today, it's 55 degrees. We're going to try it. Here we go. Whoa. Something's not right. That was weird. Don't know why it came up crooked like that. I was pretty deep in the break. Maybe I did forget how to do this. Oh well. We are in the air. That was ugly. Minutes till sunset. I'm just now taking off, so strobe lights are all on. If I go out every couple of nights and fly, I feel like my confidence is pretty good and I get better at it. But 6 weeks, that's a long time. It gets dark early. By the time I get home, it's about too late. I've been tired. You know, life. But it is a pretty night tonight. Kind of cloudy, but that's okay. Wanted to wish everybody a Merry Christmas. Moon's pretty. Don't know if you can see that or not. Okay, right now is official sunset. We'll go back and look here. Yep, it's gone. Okay, I got 30 minutes. So, the cage problem, when I got ready to take off the other day, there was a pretty good headwind. The lines push on the cage like they do on a trike, and my prop went into the line for the netting. Didn't hurt the prop, just took a couple of lines out of the net, pretty minor, but that darn cage flexed. I put a lower hoop on it. Now I've got another one on it, so it's got all sorts of reinforcements on it now. Had an oil leak, so I replaced the O-ring and the base gasket on that cylinder. Everything looks good in there. It seems to be okay. My tachometer hour meter quit. And I put it on my fender now. I don't know if you can see it there. I'll take a picture of it and throw it up here. But I really like it down there. But evidently, I've got my tack set wrong because it only reads about half. I did have to add about 3 feet of wire. The instructions said you can do that, but you might need to do more wraps. So I think I need to wrap my spark plug wire a little more. But we can do that. No big deal. Oh, it feels so good to get back in the air. after a couple of weeks, you start to get a little antsy, and then after that, it's like, well, no big deal, I'll get back. Then you start to procrastinate, and before you know it, a month is gone, and now 6 weeks. Dang. I think I bought just 5 gallons of gas in October, and I got about a gallon left in here, so that's terrible. This has probably been one of my worst years as far as getting a lot of flights in. It's not really been the weather or a lot of the malfunctions, just things always seem to happen, you know, there's always something going on those good days. Then when I have lots of time, it's raining or windy or something. Days and I can retire. I'm going to go part-time. Then I'm going to fly every morning and fly every evening. That is good. And I'll just work a few hours during the day, maybe. That's the goal, anyway. My wife and I are starting to think about the 2024 fly-in and where we're going to go this year. I'd like to go to one or two that's a little bit farther away than our short area. If anybody that watches me a lot knows me, I'd like to meet some of you guys. So tell me one of the fly-ins you're going to, if you would. And, you know, something about the fly-in that you like. I'd like to go to a really big one like Bad Apple someday, but I'm not sure I'm ready for that. We might, I don't know. But we usually go to the small ones where there's like 50 or less people. Usually quite a few less than 50. I feel pretty comfortable around that number. But I'm not opposed to going to a bigger one. It is pretty smooth tonight. When I got ready to load my paramotor, the windsock was straight out. It's like, well, I don't know. Then I kind of ho-hummed around a little bit. By the time I got ready to go, there was no wind at all. Oh, another big upgrade I did, and I'm liking it so far. I got some gel ear cups. Got them on Amazon, and some of those are like $40 or $50. And I found a place on Amazon that had 3M brands, I don't remember, they were less than 20. I tell you what, they're comfy. They feel colder than the ones I had before, but of course it was about 20 degrees warmer last time I flew, so there's that. Not feeling very adventurous tonight. Like I said, it's been a while since I've been flying, so just wanting to get my bearings back, try to remember how to do all this stuff. Little bouncy over the boo plant there. There's the boo plant, and there's my house. Seems appropriate. Ooh, little bumpy right there. Bumpy right there. It's going to be dark in 15 minutes. Yeah, temperature wise, this isn't bad at all. I got my lightweight gloves, got a kind of a lightweight, I guess it's called lightweight winter jacket. It's not my heavy one. I got a real nice snowsuit for Christmas. We did our Christmas today, so I'll be able to really bundle up in the cold weather. Ready for snow flights now. A lot of pretty lights down there. wonder if I can see my daughter. I'll have to try to turn and look here in a second. They've really got their yard all decorated up. Yeah. See it? They'll get a kick out of that. The old marijuana plant lit up tonight. I got 10 minutes to land. I think we're going to make it. We're going to make it. About need some landing lights on my runway.
My best, but I'm out of practice.